Morning, everybody. This is K. Balakrishna. Presently, we are dealing with a subject called as marketing management. And in the marketing management, there are two types of things called as consumer marketing and industrial marketing. Consumer marketing is a process of marketing consumer products, and industrial marketing is a process of marketing industrial products. What are consumer products? Consumer products are the products which are produced, which are purchased by the consumers. And industrial products are the products which are purchased by the industries, especially to produce the consumer products. For example, sugar is a consumer product, but the same sugar is used for the preparation of various other supplements in case of industrial market. Sugar cane, if you consume it, it is a consumer product. If it is used for producing the sugar, it is called as an industrial product. In this way, we can clearly say that whether the product is a consumer product or an industrial product based upon the intake. If we intake the milk, it is called as a consumer product. If the milk is used for the preparation of milk products, then it is called as an industrial product. If we consume the oil, then it is called as a consumer product. But if all same oil is used for producing the oil part, then it is called as industrial product. I will be sharing you the screen so that you know what you mean by consumer marketing and what you mean by industrial marketing. Together with this, we will also know what are the characteristics of consumer marketing and what are the characteristics of industrial marketing. Consumer marketing versus industrial marketing. Consumer products are the products which are produced. Consumer marketing is a process of marketing of consumer products, and industrial marketing is a process of marketing of industrial products. In this class, we will know what are industrial products and what are consumer products and what are their characteristics. Consumer marketing has grown its importance nowadays because most of the marketing is totally buyer's market. That is, large number of buyers are present when compared to the sellers. It is the buyer who takes the ultimate important decision whether to purchase the product or not. He may or may not be influenced by other promotional elements. There are many types of consumer products. First one is called as convenience product. Kapa is a consumer product. Candy is a consumer product. Soap is a consumer product. And fast foods that we eat are called as consumer products. Here, the things why we are saying so, because least amount of effort may be spent for taking a decision. They are also called as second category of consumer products are called as shopping products. Shopping products includes the clothing, furniture, appliances, used cars, etc. taken. Because less amount of collection of data, less amount of effort is taken for purchasing these products. And so specialty products are third category of consumer products. Here, certain amount of effort is taken by the company in order to purchase these products. Example, various cars produced, various clothes produced, designer equipment, clothes produced, and photographic equipment with high price. They require huge analysis before purchase. Such are called as specialty. Unsought products. These are the products which we do not want to buy, but we are forced to buy. For example, life insurance products. We are not designated to buy these products, but we do not want to buy these products, but the need and necessity drives us to purchase them. What are the characteristics of consumer products? First and the foremost characteristic is economy of scale. If they are produced in large quantities, prices will be reduced and sales will be maximized. Next one is number of buyers. Consumer products, number of buyers is very, very huge. There are large number of buyers for consumer products. Next, availability of substitutes. Each product has a number of substitutes. Next, change in fashion. In a sense, there will be a change in trend from each and every day regarding the consumer products. Presence of buyers. there are a large number of buyers, so it's called as a buyer market for consumer products. Elasticity of demand. The demand continuously changes because the needs and wants continuously changes, trends continuously changes, so the demand for the products also continuously changes. Next, volume of purchase. They are purchased in small quantities when compared to industrial purchases. Unit value. The per unit value of these products is usually very, very high, very low. Competition. The competition is very, very immense. We can say that there will be a large number of alternatives available for the customers in the market. Next, promotional effort. It requires a huge support from the advertising, sales promotion, and other promotion needs. Influenced by emotions. Worried ad is influenced by jealousiness, by emotion called as jealousiness in the advertisements. Store well for happiness. In this way, each product is linked with certain type of emotions. Next is technical training. Technical training in the sense there is a huge amount of technology used for promoting these products. Next, intermediation. Sometimes the middlemen like wholesalers, retailers, agents, brokers, etc. are used for distributing these products. Now, what is mean by industrial marketing? Industrial marketing is a process of purchasing and selling industrial products. The main difference between an industrial and consumer product depends upon its utility. First, the type of industrial product is called as materials and parts. Material means the raw material which is used for the factories. So we already discussed, like the pulp which is used for the paper industry, raw material which is used for the manufacturing industry. Next, component materials and parts used in the used for the preparation of consumer goods. The spare parts used for the car and automobile and bike industry. Second type of products are capital items, like accessory equipment, installations, and factory equipment, etc. Third type of industrial product is supplies. There is one difference between supplies as well as spare parts. Spare parts are found after the production, but supplies may not be found after the production. For example, paints, lubricants, paper, coal, oil, diesel, petrol, kerosene, etc. are used in the production process. What are the characteristics of industrial marketing? First and foremost characteristic is it requires huge investment. To purchase an equipment, it requires huge amount of money. Only option left in the industrial marketing is to lease the asset when compared to the buying option. It is profitable. It's complex nature of products. The products are completely complex in nature. They consist of huge amount of training is required for purchasing them and using the industrial products. For example, paper machinery is an industrial product. Paper is a consumer product. We do not require training to purchase the paper, to use the paper, but we require training to use the paper machinery. It's a derived demand. The demand for the industrial good depends upon the demand for the consumer. For example, the demand for the paper industry, paper machinery depends upon the demand for the paper. Limited number of buyers. Limited number of buyers in the sense there are less number of industrial users. These industrial users are also located in a small belt so that they can be found and located easily. Its demand is also inelastic because it depends upon the demand of the consumer needs. Buying is always a group process. Here, one product is not purchased at a time, but huge quantity of products is purchased at a time. Not small quantities, but huge quantities are purchased at a time. Higher purchase value of industrial goods. Here, the goods are not purchased. The value of each good is not small. To buy a paper, it costs around 10 to 15 rupees. But to buy a proper machinery, it requires 10 to 15 lakhs or 10 to 15 crores. So, huge amount of value power is present for industrial goods. After sales service, you buy a proper machinery only if the service is available. Ninth one is seller's reputation. If the seller is having higher reputation, then he searches the entire market and locates the leasing. Instead of purchase, since they are involved with higher amount of money, leasing would be a better option than compared to buying of these industrial goods. Next, these are rational purchases. Rational in the sense, this does not deal with any emotions. They deal with the technicality, they deal with the possession. Next point is greater awareness of buyers. The buyers have complete picture regarding the technicality of the product. Shorter channels of distribution. In case of consumer distribution, long channels are used. There are large number of intermediaries. But in case of industrial distribution, very, very short channels are used. This is a complete framework regarding what do you mean by consumer marketing and what do you mean by industrial marketing. Consumer marketing is one which is used for marketing the consumer products, and industrial marketing is one which is used for marketing the industrial products. Thank you.